Hey, what is up everybody? Welcome to the channel. My name is John Denton, and if you're here, that means you're joining me on a journey through the past, the present, and the future of hip-hop, the past, the present, and future of all music. And yes, 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 I have been seeing the comments. Of course, I've been seeing the comments, the endless, relentless comments, telling me that I need to do a weekend season, that I need to do weekend's trilogy, mixtape, compilation, whatever you want to call it. So we're starting, I get it, it's three things, I can't do one video on the whole thing, that would be insane. So I'm starting with House of Balloons, the first one, the Spotify version. I know some people yell at me, you should do it off this or this. It's just, this is the way it's being done, okay? I'm sure it's all good. I'm very, very excited to hear this. Obviously, I am a fan of everything, though. Pretty much, not everything, but a lot of the Weeknd's music that I've heard. Whether it's stuff that I've reacted to over on Rock Reacts, which is stuff I've heard on the radio, more recent stuff, etc. Very, very excited to hear, you know, where he came from musically. So, without further ado, make sure you subscribe if you're new. Make sure you're turning on the notification bell. My notification bell situation is low, and I know it's because I'm not asking people to switch down that bell. So smash that bell like Dark Souls. Let's go. Trilogy. Hi for this is the first track. We're going in.
You don't know what's in store. Lay yourself beside me.
Although it feels a little strange to be put into the role of one of Abel's sexual conquests, I'm guessing the point of this track is like you're coming along as the listener for this experience, as well as obviously him talking to a young lady about a situation that they may or may not get into. But musically, I love the way that the beat was kind of like the reverb. It was almost like it was in another room, and then it came through, and then obviously when it dropped with that weird like straight away.
We'll be good, I promise. We'll be so
wow. Oh my goodness. Got to sit up. Oh my goodness. What a start. Oh my goodness. I don't even have any words. That's why sometimes reaction channels beat reviews, because you just see it. You just get to see it. It would take me ages to come up with the right things to actually say about that and to try and break it down. Sometimes you just have to let the wave hit you. My goodness, what an opener, what a track. Okay, I'm gonna stop this because I just read on the Genius, I was just looking at the Genius, and it said that the original version had a different sample. So what I'm gonna do, because I don't want this video to get blocked, I'm going to have a little listen on YouTube to the original one. See how different it is. Okay, so something to do with an uncleared sample. They're very similar. They're very, very similar. I'm going to stick with Spotify versions because I'm pretty sure the other versions will get the video blocked. I've had a lot of issues with videos getting blocked recently. It is exhausting. So I'm going to stick with the Spotify versions. You know, by all means, tell me in the comments which versions are different or what should be listened to. I can always go back and listen to it. But hopefully you guys understand this is the way. This makes most sense for the video, and probably the only way I actually get the video on the internet. Doing things you never thought you'd do. Maybe leave the life in you. He's what you want. He's what you want. He's what you want. Yeah, that was a funny one because obviously it did sound quite different actually, the more, you know, had the guitar in the original version. So I did like that track, but you know, I kind of caught myself thinking, right, does this feel right? I don't know. I'm just going to try not to get too in my own head about that sort of stuff. I can always go and listen to those versions afterwards. But again, there's something about The Weeknd's kind of gnawing darkness that is so interesting compared to most. I don't really like most R&B. I remember getting hammered on that Chris Brown Drake video over Rock Reacts just before the channel ended for not really liking it because it's just never been my cup of tea. But this kind of darker wave of R&B, you know, whether it's this or Frank Ocean, I wouldn't say Frank Ocean is necessarily dark, but it just has so much more to it to me. But this, he himself, whether it's a character or him or a combination of the both, has he's like, it was almost like a vampire or something like that. There's an evil charm to him that is intoxicating, and that's kind of the point, right? Amazing. This song's amazing. I don't even know what to say to this music. This is absolutely incredible. I can't believe I never heard this before.
And it's 6:30. Read skies, cause time don't exist. And when the stars shine back to the crib, Super got some brand new tables, all glass, and it's 4 feet wide. But it's a must to get us 10 feet high. Ain't no offense, though, I promise you. If you a real man, dude, you gon' side the truth. But I'm a nice dude with some nice dreams.
I don't even know if you can see that. I need to make a sign, a proper sign. I'm gonna make one. That was unbelievable. That was unbelievable. I can't even get my head around how brilliant that was. Not only musically, not only the second half, the Glass Table Girls, where it sounds like some fucking early Nine Inch Nails song, but with this beautiful, unbelievable voice over the top of it. But the fucking metaphors in there about panic and anxiety and panic attacks and everything like that. Oh my. I was going to say, why did you lot not tell me about this? But you've been telling me about this for a long time, but I didn't realise. Because I've heard lots of his music and I like his music. But I've been hearing more the Starboy era of The Weeknd, which I do like. But this is something very different indeed. Very different.
Into the evening, complaints from the tenants. Got the walls kicking like they 6 months pregnant, life living. Let the world listen if a hater's card slipping, then my nigga stay tight. My back like Pippin, holding cups, paint a picture so vivid. Face try to mimic, get girls timid, but all that. push you to the limit, push you through the pain. I push you for the pleasure like a virgin to the game. A virgin to that money, a virgin to the fame. Straight bar hopping to the music of the ambiance. Get shit popping, zombies of the night. Niggas ain't talking if they
Dude, this is absolutely insane. This is insane. I can't actually wrap my head around how unbelievably good this is. I mean, maybe it would. Maybe the second track on this remastered version didn't hit quite as much because it was the changed version. But the other three?
All that money, the money.
Supposed to do? What the fuck?
And get you dancing with the devil. Take a shot of this, but I'm warning you. I'm on that shit that you can't smell, baby. Put down your perfume. Bring your love, baby. I could bring my shit. Bring the drugs, baby. I could bring my pain. Oh, I got my heart right here. Oh, I got my scars right here.
I didn't even know what to say. I don't even know what to say, guys. Actually, I do. The last couple of weeks, you know, just been having a little bit of a crisis of confidence with this channel. Not that this channel has been amazing since I've been doing it on my own, and the growth and the views and the support, all amazing. But I think people can understand it's a little difficult to come off a channel that was nearly at 300,000 subscribers, and you know, you put out a video by Big Artist and the views would be crazy, 100k, you know, within a few days, all that sort of stuff, and to try and rebuild from that. And, you know, sometimes they're putting out the videos and the views aren't popping on some of them and things like that, And I'm like, you know, fuck me, have I got it in me? You know, I've not been very well the last few weeks as well. And I was like, have I got it in me? Have I fucking got it in me to go and do this again, to try and do this again, but without playing a novelty card so much, and to try and do it in a different way? And then you hear something like that, and then you hear something like that, but like this whole fucking record, but like that. You're damn right. You're damn right. I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere. I was not expecting this to be this. I was not expecting this.
Understand, your body wants it. I know your thoughts. Oh, you bout it. With your Louis V bag, tats on your arms, high heel shoes make you 6 feet tall. Everybody wants it, you can have them all.
It's quite predictably, I'm loving this now.
I'll supply it for it. I got you, girl. Oh, I got it, girl. I got you, girl. Oh, I got you, girl. Loving, I need more, I need yours. She ain't looking for that unconditional. What the fuck these bitches on? They want what I'm sitting on. Whoa, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, I got it, girl. So, mama, please stop.
I've been thinking this the whole way through, but it's like Frank Ocean's like the angel, and Abel's like the devil. Of, you know, two sides of the same coin, these beautiful, incredible, soaring, transcending voices. But you're not hearing Frank Ocean say a line like, and if she stops, then I might get violent. Angel and the devil. This second part, I'm not loving as much. It is a bit self-indulgent. I still kind of feel like that from before. The first part is fantastic, but it still just sounds amazing. And I'm just getting lost in it, really. But that was like a you know, record scratch.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Fucking good.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Cause with this money comes problems, and with these problems come solutions. And I use them when I'm fading, I forget.
I always want you when I come and go.
Another astonishing piece of music. Astonishing piece of music. It's so dark, and it's so filled with woe and regret. And while it's fairly simple in its subject matter, it backs that up with the musicality. You know, sometimes, you know me, I'm a lyrics guy, but sometimes you don't need lyrics if you can just show the mood with the music. Astonishing again.
Chance like this, you may never get to show off what you talking about. Yes, you like to tease, baby. In the reality, you don't know how to please, baby. Blue ball queen, take your fucking seat, baby, and ride it out now.
It's like the Me Too anthem, this album.
And if you're swinging like you're dumber than the next man in the bathroom, I hear noises in the bathroom. Baby, it's okay. Now we trade places, rehearse lies to them, and then we fuck faces. Yeah, we know just how to get a buzz.
Quite a self-indulgent second half, but musically it sounded good, and you kind of needed that breathing room a little bit. And I'm not going to have a go at Abel the Weeknd for being self-indulgent, because that's the whole fucking theme of the record. So yeah, if he has those self-indulgent moments musically in the record, it makes sense. That's not my favourite track on the album by any stretch, but it's still very good. But compared to House of Balloons, compared to Wicked Games, and compared to Coming Down, it's not there. Well, we've got the track The Knowing now, which I believe is actually the last track, and they've added an extra track for this Spotify remaster, whatever it is, the full release. So I'll listen to both, but I understand that The Knowing is the proper last track. That was such a perfect album closer, thematically, musically, everything, that I am actually reluctant to go and listen to this final track that they put on there called 28. I'm going to listen to it because it's part of what I'm listening to, and it's a Weeknd song, so, you know, it could be amazing. But just know that I know, I have the knowing that that's where it's supposed to end, and that's how you close an album, that level of atmosphere, but also thematically and everything like that. That's what makes The Weeknd interesting, even though he's not necessarily a very relatable character to me, apart from some of the things that he talks about. The fact that he is self-aware enough to look for the hypocrisy in his actions and his subject matter and the failings of his own character in these scenarios that he's created is what makes him far more interesting. And then musically, his voice is just absolutely astonishing. So with the Childish 28 track.
Cause I wanna fuck, cause you could've been the one. Gotta change my number twice a month when you could've simply kept it on the down low.
Oh.
You'd be living in my sheets. I wouldn't have shown you any love. I'm so wrong, I'm so wrong.
To be fair, that song was fucking great, so I'm glad that I listened to it, even though it did feel like a bonus track, but it was really, really, really good. What can I say, though? What can I say? Well, genuinely, what can I say about that as a body of work? I don't understand how he's got two more just in this trilogy. Are they all that good? How could they possibly even remotely all be that good? I kind of had my mind blown by the time we even got to Wicked Games. And then the rest was just a float back down to earth. An amazing body of work. Amazing. Amazing. Like, I always knew I liked The Weeknd from pretty much the first time I heard him with I Can't Feel My Face. But then, even more so, like, I do like Starboy. I liked Call Out My Name. The Hills, amazing song. But this? Different level entirely. I mean, there's definitely element, like I said, there's elements of early Nine Inch Nails in there. He sounds like Michael Jackson sometimes when he sings. He's the evil Frank Ocean. It's just. And then the Wicked Games and House of Balloons, dude. I don't even know what happened. I'm just going to have to watch it back in the edit. I don't even know what happened during those for me. So, I mean, shout out to everybody, and there has been so many of you, hundreds if not thousands of you, hammering me to do this. You were all right. You were all correct. Thank you very much. I am absolutely back on my fucking shit. I am back in my bag when it comes to this channel. Rebuild season is getting stronger now. Fuck any negativity. Fuck a confidence drop. We're going places. I promise you, we're going places. Thank you very, very, very much for watching. Please do subscribe if you're new. Please do turn on a notification bell as well, because that will massively help. We're going to be doing the next part of this trilogy very, very, very soon. So look out for that one. And yeah, make sure if you leave down below, if you get to the end, tell me below. Unsubbed, unsubscribe, tell me down below. Don't actually unsubscribe to the channel. It's just a bit of fun. It came from the JPEG Mafia thing. Gonna get into a thing on the channel, because it's just fun to see that. I like their video, unsubscribe, all that sort of stuff. It's funny, and it's funny for new people to come in and see that as well. So make sure unsub, unsubscribe below if you got through to the end. Don't actually unsubscribe. You guys understand. You guys aren't stupid. All right, that's it. Like, share the video. If anybody wants to put it on the Weeknd's Reddit or anything like that, that stuff makes a real difference if it gets up to the top of an artist's Reddit. I can't do it myself because you can't self-promote on Reddit. Check out the Discord, all the stuff below. I'll shut up now. This video is really long. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.